her being ill. In that way, you can use in spite of. Instead of in spite of, you can use despite. Despite her illness or despite her being ill, she came to class. In that way, you can join the sentences. All the sentences that we have discussed for this example are correct. The way in which you use the connector, you have to change the form of the remaining sentence. That is the main condition. Query number 3. I gave you a nice pen yesterday. Now you have to change the sentence into passive voice. Who gave you a nice pen? I gave you. And that is the subject. What did I do? I gave. So gave is the verb. Now I gave what? The answer is a nice pen. And I gave a nice pen to whom? The answer is you. Here you can find two objects in my sentence. The one object, that is you, and the second object, that is a nice pen. When there are two objects, one is considered as a direct object and the second is considered as an indirect object. You can change the sentence into passive voice using any of these objects. So your sentence can be started with the word you or with the help of a nice pen in the beginning. Let's have both the answers together so you can understand different correct answers for the same sentence. You were given a nice pen by me yesterday. So in this sentence, I have taken you as an object. You is an indirect object. The second answer begins with a nice pen. The sentence is, a nice pen was given to you by me yesterday. Here I have taken a nice pen, that is the direct object. So using any of them, you can begin your sentence and it may be in passive voice. Query number 4. Mr. Mehta has distributed his property blank his two sons. Two is slant. Just to give you more idea. Mr. Shah has distributed his property blank his three sons. And the options are among and between. When we are talking about two persons, things or objects, we have to use between. My house is between a temple and a mosque. So I'm talking about two things. But if we talk about something which is more than two, we have to use among. Mr. Shah has distributed his property among his three sons. So these are two answers. Now query number 5. Little knowledge blank always dangerous. Are, is, has, have. Now little knowledge, it's a singular, and that's why the correct answer is. Bread and butter blank his favorite snack. Are, is, have, has. Now the subject has two words in its, you know, group, bread and butter. And to make, to confuse you, the connector and is used there. So you can consider the thing as two. It is bread and butter. But sometimes two things or more than two things are joined together to indicate one unit. When I say bhaji pao, right? So bhaji and pao, actually there are two things. So in the same manner, bread and butter, they come together, they become one unit for food. That's why it indicates singular form. So bread and butter is his favorite snack. And the last query of today's lecture. Anand blank the food which his mother would prepare. And food which his mother would prepare blank by Anand. And in the blank, you have to use will plus eat, appropriate form. So Anand is a person who will do the task of eating in future. So Anand is a subject in the first sentence and the subject is there before the verb. So it is in active voice. Will is already given in the bracket. So you have to use simple future tense with active voice. So the answer would be Anand will eat. And the second option or the second sentence, food which his mother would prepare, blank by Anand. Now before the verb there are many words, food which his mother would prepare. Ultimately you are talking about food, you are not talking about mother. So food is an object and food is thing which will be eaten by Anand. So ultimately before the verb we have food as a word and that is an object. So the sentence number 2 is in passive mode, and food which his mother would prepare will be eaten by Anand. Yes, these are your answers. Will plus eat, will plus be plus eaten. Now, this is the end of the session, and I would like to say that when you face any question paper, you don't have to get confused. Just try to look at the sentence, try to understand what is asked, try to find out keywords, try to get the idea, apply your mind, use your proper structure for the proper sentences, and then you may use the correct, you know, answer. So English grammar is really very easy. It's very simple. The thing which you have to do is just focus on each and every component of sentence. By that way, you would be able to get good marks in your examination. All the best for the examinations. Thank you very much.